Hi guys, welcome to Rajshree Food. This is the Bombay chef Varun Inamdar, and today I'm here to sizzle your kitchen with something spicy. Yes, indeed, I'm making paneer tikkas. So let's begin.
So first things first, I'm going to cut the paneer into thick dices. The size of the vegetables or the paneer can be of your choice. So they can be bigger, smaller. Similarly, I'm going to cut the capsicums. So I've taken all the three colors, green, yellow, and red.
Similarly, if you see, I've also cut the onions and cap. These are regular red onions. I've just cut these into quarters, released each petal, and I'm keeping this aside. Now let's make the marination.
For the marination, first that goes in is some yogurt, some red chili powder. Now this can be a good mix of a chili that gives you color as well as flavor, some chaat masala powder, salt to taste, mustard oil, turmeric powder, ajwain or carom seeds, and ginger garlic. Finally, I'm also going to add in a little bit of lemon juice and give this entire thing a thorough mix.
Now that the marinade is ready, I'm throwing in the vegetables and the paneer. So first, the slices of onions, peppers, and chunks of cottage cheese.
I'm going to stir this very lightly, making sure it evenly mixes, but without breaking the pieces of paneer.
Once this is nicely mixed, I'm going to leave this aside for 15 minutes so that it nicely marinates.
Now that this is marinated, let's start putting these vegetables and paneer on a skewer. I'm going to just keep alternating it with vegetables and paneer. So you can follow a pattern or you can just go as random as you wish. But just make sure each paneer has a vegetable before and after it. So here I have the first one.
Well, if you wish to make chicken tikka masala, do not forget to log on to Get Curried. The link is there in the description box below. Now that our skewers are ready, time is now to heat some oil along with a teaspoon of butter.
I'm going to keep the flame on moderate heat. The butter is heated up. I'm placing these paneer tikka sticks.
We have to keep turning these till they become nice and charred on all the sides. This tikka now has beautifully scorched on all the sides. Off goes the flame and let's begin the plating.
Now just to add in some more color, I'm taking in some fresh mint leaves and roughly giving them a chop. I'm gonna mix these with slices of onions, a wedge of lime, and a little bit of chaat masala. Give this a nice mix. So here you have your instant lachha pyaz ready, which is now going on the plate along with the paneer tikka and along with this, some more lime.
So here you have the paneer tikka, which is ready. Do try it at home and do let us know how you like it. And wait for what next the Bombay chef gets into your kitchen.